Hello all, my name is Krishnag and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we'll be discussing about rectified linear unit activation function. In my previous video, I've already discussed about vanishing gradient problem. Please have a look into that before understanding rectified linear unit, because we need to understand the purpose why ReLU activation function is basically used. So let us just revise some of the concepts of sigmoid activation function and threshold activation function. So over here, the sigmoid activation function looks at, and the equation is basically given by 1 divided by 1 plus e to the power of minus z. Now this z is basically the summation of weights multiplied by the input plus bias in each and every layer for each and every neurons. When that z value is passed through this particular equation, then the sigmoid activation function transforms those values between 0 to 1. Okay, and this is the curve that basically looks like. Okay, now understand that the activation function, the sigmoid activation function performs in that way. But in the case of backpropagation, whenever the weights are getting updated, we need to also find out the derivative of the sigmoid activation function. And always remember, the derivative of the sigmoid activation function will be ranging between 0 to 0.25. And that is mathematically proved. Whenever you try to find out the derivative of this particular value, always it will be between 0 to 0.25. Now, if I take the example of threshold activation function, in threshold activation function, the equation is basically given by 1 minus e to the power of minus 2z divided by e to the 1 plus e to the power of minus 2z. Now, when I pass my z function, z value over here, this will transform the value between minus 1 to plus 1. Okay. But similarly, suppose if I try to implement tan h, that is threshold activation function, in each and every layer, right? At that time, you'll see that during the back propagation, if I find out the derivative of this threshold activation function, at that time, you'll be seeing that the value will be ranging between 0 to 1. This particular red curve line, right, indicates that only. Now, because of this problem, the vanishing gradient problem occurs, because understand the weight updation formula. In the weight updation formula, it says that W new is equal to W old minus the learning rate multiplied by derivative of loss divided by that specific weight. Now, when we are calculating this, this will be calculating with the help of chain rule. If you don't know chain rule, please watch my videos, guys. Then only you'll be able to understand this. During the chain rule, I'll be having multiple derivatives value over here. And suppose with the help of sigmoid activation function or threshold activation function, I know the derivative will always be less than 1. Okay? During the back propagation. Right? Because of this particular diagram that I have actually drawn. Okay? Now suppose if I have 3 derivatives over here, which is impacting the blue. At that time, suppose my first derivative is 0.25. My second derivative, I found out by the derivative value is 0.10. And third is basically 0.001. Now in this case, if I try to multiply this derivative, it will be a very small number. And now when I try to replace this small number over here, and suppose if I take my learning rate as 1, what will happen? There will be a minor change in W old. That basically means that this W new will be approximately equal to W old. Now because of this minor change, what will happen that it will take much time to converge, right? In the gradient descent curve that we see, right? It will take much time to converge. Now, in order to prevent this, how does ReLU help us to do this, solve this particular problem? That is, you know, vanishing gradient problem that we'll solve. Let me just draw what exactly, how does ReLU work, okay? So, I'm just going to rub this. Now, ReLU activation function, first of all, we'll try to understand how the diagram is basically related. Now, suppose this is my diagram, okay, and this is my z value. Now my z value is plus 1, it may be 2 3 4, and similarly over here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Now ReLU activation function, and this is my f, right, my f value. Now ReLU activation function has a very easy formula. It says max of 0, z, okay, that's it, max of 0, z. That basically means if your z value is negative, at that time, these all values will be equal to 0. Whenever z value is positive, then it will be increasing. Right? So, whenever the z value is 1, at that time, you can see over here, right? If my z is positive, that basically means max of 0, positive will be a positive number. So, if my z value is 1, at that time, this function will also give me 1. And this is a simple formula for ReLU, that is rectified linear unit. Now, how this is basically solving the problem, that we'll try to understand. Let me just go into the right-hand side and draw the derivative of this particular. Whenever we are doing the back propagation, what will be the derivative of a ReLU activation function? I'll just try to draw that particular diagram over here in the right hand side. So as I said, okay, this is my z value. Now when I find out the derivative, remember guys, this particular line, if I try to see, this line has a 45 degree. Now always remember, if I want to find out any derivative value for this particular line, the value will always be 1. Can anybody tell me why? Okay, you can pause and think for it, but I'll just give you the answer, because whenever I'm trying to find out derivative, I know that tan 45 is nothing but 1. So whenever I want to find out the derivative of any positive value, in the case of rectified linear unit, I will always be getting the output as 1. Okay, now this will be always my output. Now always remember, what about this particular points? These points are basically constants, because you can see that it is just having one value itself throughout all this negative. And if you try to find out the derivative of a constant, that basically means that it is going to become zero. It will all have zero value. But you should understand one more thing. When you're making this zero, when you try to find out the derivative of zero, you cannot find out the derivative of zero, guys. Okay? Because zero is not differentiable. I hope you remember this concept from your 11th and 12th standard, right? Zero, you cannot find out the zero derivative of a zero. You can find out the derivative of constant. You can find out the derivative of some positive value, but you cannot find out the derivative of constant, right? Oh, sorry, of zero. So this particular zero, we cannot find it out, and this can also be solved. Okay, this can also be solved, because this particular value, we just have to make the minor change, which we'll see in the later section of this particular video itself. Now, understand by this particular term that what I'm saying, the derivative of function with respect to derivative z for ReLU, right? For ReLU, it will either be 0 or 1. How it will be 0 or 1? Just let me write it down. So I'll write it down. Whenever the z value is greater than 0, that basically means the derivative will be 1. If the z value is less than 0, that means the derivative will be 0. Now, this is only the simple concept about ReLU. Whenever I'm finding the derivative, it'll just go and check the z value. If it is greater than 0, the derivative will be 1. If it is less than 0, it will be 0. Now understand, find out the difference between the derivative of this and the sigmoid one. In sigmoid, the derivative always ranges between 0 to 0.25, right? And in tan h, it is always less than 1. But here, you just have two values, 1 and 0. Now when you have two values, 1 and 0, now you try to apply this particular formula in the derivatives. Suppose, the same bit updation formula, I'll just write it down. So here I'll write y old is equal to y new minus the learning rate derivative of loss with respect to derivative of w. Let this be some chain rule. It has three derivatives, suppose. Now suppose this all derivatives value will be either 1, right? Suppose all are 1. Then this derivative calculation will be 1. Now, whenever I try to update over here, this 1 into learning rate as 1, right? This will be 1, right? Now, suppose whatever W new will be, there will be a little bit, you know, difference between W old and new now. It will not be having that vanishing gradient problem now, you know? And then our equation will get converged, our weights will get converged easy. But there is also one problem with this ReLU function, which is actually fixed by leaky ReLU. Now, suppose I told you that either of my derivative is either 1 or 0. Okay, now suppose in one of the case, my derivative becomes 0. Now, when my derivative becomes zeros, what will be the problem over here? Just imagine. This all value output of the derivative chain will be 0. When I try to replace it over here, this will be 0. And then I'll have W old is equal to W new. So that is of no use, right? And this will basically create your dead neuron or dead activation function. You can also say it as dead neuron or dead activation function. That basically means nothing, no process is basically happening. I'll try to explain you how to fix this particular problem. To fix this particular problem, you have a concept called as leaky ReLU. Okay. Now, I hope you understood how the derivative of this particular value is there. What is ReLU? ReLU is basically saying max of 0, comma z. That's it. Okay. Derivative of the ReLU has basically this particular equation or this particular technique of understanding what will be the derivative of z. If it is greater than 0, it will be 1. If it is less than 0, it will be 0. Right? So very much simple and clear. Now let us go and see that how do we fix this dead neuron, dead activation function. Okay, how to fix if I have this particular value as 0. So in order to fix this, I'm just going to rub this again. In order to fix this, I have a concept called as ReLU. Now this particular ReLU basically says that we will try to add some value over here. That basically means my line will not be exactly 0 for the negative numbers. Instead, it will be adding some small value within this particular variable. So this will basically become like, if I want to write it down over here, if my z is greater than 0, right, then here I will be having z value. That is what this particular value says, right? Right? Now, if my z is less than 0, then what I'll do is that I will just try to add one value like 0.01 value to this particular value itself. Okay, this 0.01 multiplied by a, it may be some a value. Now this 0.01 will actually create a line over here like this. Now imagine this particular value, whenever I do the derivative with respect to the z. Now suppose this is my z, okay, with respect to the z, right? Whenever if I'm trying to do the derivative of this with respect to that, like derivative of 0.01 multiplied by z divided by z, at that time you'll be finding that your output will be 0.01. It will not be zero. That basically means we are solving the problem of the dead neuron during the back propagation by using the leaky ReLU. So this is, I'm going to just specify over here, leaky ReLU. So whenever you think, like suppose if in a neural network you are having 100 neurons, and from that you think that based on the training cycle, right? If you see that you have a problem of deactivating the neuron getting dead, and suppose from the 100 neurons, 50 neurons are getting dead. We basically need to try to apply leaky ReLU.